हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज अंकित गुप्ता एंड वेलकम यू ऑल वंस मोर इन ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ जीके। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव रेड अबाउट क्रिकेट, फुटबॉल, हॉकी एंड कबड्डी। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट नेशनल एंड गैलेंट्री अवार्ड्स। सो डू यू नो विच इज द हाईएस्ट सिविलियन अवार्ड इन इंडिया? सो राइट आंसर इज भारत रत्न। एंड सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज विच इज द सेकेंड हाईएस्ट सिविलियन अवार्ड इन इंडिया? सो करेक्ट आंसर इज पद्म विभूषण। भारत रत्न,
भारत रत्न अवार्ड। भारत रत्न अवार्ड इज द हाईएस्ट सिविलियन अवार्ड ऑफ आवर कंट्री। भारत रत्न अवार्ड वॉज स्टार्टेड टू गिव फ्रॉम 2 जनवरी 1954। दिस अवार्ड इज गिवन फॉर एक्सेप्शनल सर्विस इन एडवांसमेंट ऑफ आर्ट, लिटरेचर एंड साइंस एंड इन रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ पब्लिक सर्विस ऑफ द हाईएस्ट ऑर्डर। भारत रत्न अवार्ड इज प्रेजेंटेड बाई द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया and it is not mandatory that Bharat Ratna be awarded every year. The name of the awardees are recommended to the President by the Prime Minister of India, and the President has the final authority to select the winner out of maximum 3 recommendations given by the Prime Minister of India. The medal looks like a paper leaf with the text Bharat Ratna in Devanagari script on front side. It contains an image of sun on it, and the reverse side of this medal contains a platinum state emblem of India with the national motto Satyamev Jayate written in Devanagari script. The Bharat Ratna medals are produced at Alipur Mint, Kolkata, along with the other civilian and gallantry awards. It's very important. The first recipients of this award were Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, Chakrabarti Raja Gopalachari, and C.V. Raman in 1954. Mother Teresa was the first naturalized Indian citizen who received Bharat Ratna Award in 1980. There is no provision that Bharat Ratna Award should be given to Indians only, because Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan and Nelson Mandela are the two non-Indians who got Bharat Ratna Award in 1987 and 1990 respectively. Indian cricketer Sachin Tendulkar is the first sports person and the youngest Bharat Ratna Award winner who received this award in 2014 at the age of 40. Social reformer Dondokishab Karve was the oldest alive person to receive the Bharat Ratna Award in 1958 on his 100th birthday. He was popularly known to us as Maharishi Karve. Lal Bahadur Shastri, former Prime Minister of India, was the first person to be awarded posthumously in 1966. Yes friends, Lal Bahadur Shastri was the first person who received the Bharat Ratna Award in 1966 after his death. First Deputy Prime Minister of India, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, was the eldest person to receive this award in 1991 after his death, at the age of 116. M.S. Subbulakshmi, belongs from Tamil Nadu, was the first musician who got this award in 1998. Satyajit Ray was the first and only filmmaker who was conferred with this Bharat Ratna Award in 1992. The first and only person from industrialist and business background who received this award in 1992 was J.R.D. Tata.
पद्मा अवार्ड्स।
टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एन इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक स्पेशली फॉर आवर एग्जाम्स, दैट इज द पद्मा अवार्ड्स। सो देर आर थ्री पद्मा अवार्ड्स विच इज पद्म भूषण, पद्म विभूषण एंड पद्मश्री। सो इन वॉट क्रोनोलॉजी इज दैट अवार्ड गिवन एंड टू हूम दैट अवार्ड इज गिवन, हु गिव्स द अवार्ड, हाउ इज इट डिसाइडेड दैट टू द सेम पर्सन इट हैज टू बी गिवन, ऑल दोज डिटेल्स विल बी डिस्कसिंग इन दिस वीडियो। लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द बेसिक्स ऑफ दिस, दैट इज द हिस्ट्री ऑफ दिस। लेट अस मूव बैक टू 1954। ओके, 1954 Government of India thought for all the services given by the civilians we have to be giving two highest awards, and one was Bharat Ratna and the second was Padma Vibhushan. Okay, keep in mind this is in 1954. Okay, first one is Bharat Ratna and the second one is Padma Vibhushan. And in Padma Vibhushan at that point of a time there were three categories, that is Pehla Varg, second one is Dusra Varg and the third one is Tisra Varg, that is first Varg and the second Varg and third Varg, as the name itself says. The same thing became, Pehla Varg became Padma Vibhushan, Dusra Varg became Padma Bhushan and the Tisra Varg became Padma Shri. Okay, Padma Vibhushan, Padma Bhushan and the Padma Shri. Okay, so as you proceed upwards the importance increases. Okay, so Padma Shri is given first and later on if the service is even more then they are given Padma Bhushan, and after that they will be given Padma Vibhushan, and above all we have Bharat Ratna. So the first award or the highest award which is given for civilians, okay, we are talking here for civilians, the highest award which is given for civilians is, the first one is Bharat Ratna and the second one is Padma Vibhushan. Among the Padma awards it is second one, that is Padma Vibhushan. We will revise the same thing again about the Padma Awards, that is in 1954 Government of India instituted this and there were two awards, which is Bharat Ratna and Padma Vibhushan. Padma Vibhushan had Pehla Varg, Dusra Varg and Tisra Varg. I hope this is clear until here. So all the changes from Pehla Varg, Dusra Varg and Tisra Varg, it happened in 1955. So in 1954 there were especially only two awards and the categories were Pehla Varg, Dusra Varg and Tisra Varg itself. So Padma Varg is one of the highest civilian honors of India. We are not talking about military honors, they both are different. And the second one is, it is announced annually on Republic Day. So concentrate on this word, it is announced. It is not given on Republic Day, it is just announced on Republic Day. And it is given in March, April. It is given in the time of March, April by President of India itself. So now there are three awards, that is Padma Vibhushan, Padma Bhushan and Padma Shri. Padma Vibhushan is exceptional and distinguished service of high order, distinguished service. So distinguished service and again of high order and exceptional and distinguished service. So as you proceed upwards, the importance also increases. Before we move into the list of the qualifications or the services, we will discuss some most important notes which are related to Padma Awards. Please concentrate on this. That is first one, it is not given to government servants who work in PSUs. Okay, if there are doctors or scientists, they can be given. But other government servants who are working in PSUs will not be given. And initially it was not conferred posthumously. Okay, even when Bharat Ratna was started, it was not conferred posthumously. But later on, it was given only in the rare cases. This is in the case of Padma Awards, it is given in only in the rare cases posthumously. Okay, and the third one is, if a person is given Padma Award, next time to give the similar award or the above award for that same person, there has to be gap of 5 years. Let us understand this thing before. Okay, let us say that there is a person called as X and the person is given Padma Shri. Okay, the person is given Padma Shri. This comes third among the category of Padma Awards, right? And they are given Padma Shri in 2010. So now, if the person has to be given Padma Bhushan or Padma Vibhushan, then there has to be a gap of at least 5 years. That is, only after 2015 or 2016, they can be given Padma Bhushan or Padma Vibhushan. Okay, this is clear, I suppose. And that is one most important note. And the next note is that the award is only announced on Republic Day, whereas the award is given in March and April, and it is given by President of India itself. and the maximum number of awards including Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan and Padma Shri, it is only 120, not more than 120 awards can be given. In case of Bharat Ratna, the maximum awards which can be given is 3, only 3 person can be given in 1 year, okay. And the sixth one is, whenever a person is given Padma awards, it can't be used as a title for that person. So for example, if we take, there is a person called as X, then we should not address that person as Padma Shri X. But we usually do that, but it is not according to our law, okay, because it is forbidden by Article 18 of our constitution. So Article 18 comes under fundamental right itself, right? So under Article 18, these can't be used as a title. We saw that if a person has made exceptional or distinguished service, only those are given Padma awards. So we will see the list of service which are considered. We will see in this list, there are even bigger sections under this also. Under art also, there are other sections. Under social work also, there are other sections. But these are the topics which are very important. That is art, social work, public affairs, science and engineering, trade and industry, medicine, literature and education, civil service, sports and others. Okay, under these section also there are subsections which are not that important for us, but we have to remember elaborately these sections, that is art, social work, public affairs, science and engineering, trade and industry, medicine, literature and education, civil services, sports and others. These are very important services. Under these services itself, if there is exceptional or distinguished service portrayed by an individual, then that person will be conferred with the Padma Award. Till now, we have seen a lot of things related to Padma Awards. That is, it is given by President and there are 3 awards and what kind of service has to be done to be given that award. But now, we have to see who decides that so and so person has to get an award. Okay, for this, we have to look into something called as nominations. Okay, for this, we have to look into something called as nomination. Let us take the same example of X. So, if we consider that X has done an exceptional service in some category, let us say he has done some exceptional service under arts category, then that person's nomination will be filed, okay, so that so and so person has done some extra exceptional service under arts, so they deserve this Padma Award, which is Padma Shri or Padma Bhushan or Padma Vibhushan. It can be filed by the state or something, or otherwise even the individual also can file the nomination. That is, the X person itself can say that, yes, I have done some exceptional service, please consider me among the nominations. So we will consider about the Padma Award Committee. Okay, the nominations which are received are placed before the committee. So all over the India, whatever nominations we have got, all are received and are placed in front of this committee. And this committee is open to public. Like we saw earlier, the self nomination can also be made. So the committee, this is the Padma Award Committee, consists of these people. The composition of this committee is very important. Okay, and this committee is constituted by Prime Minister every year. The award is given by President. Okay, and the committee is constituted by Prime Minister. And there are bureaucrats in the committee. Okay, this is the series. Award is given by President. So the committee is constituted by Prime Minister. And the committee consists of bureaucrats. That is, it is headed by Cabinet Secretary. And the other members are Home Secretary, Secretary to President, and 4 to 6 eminent persons. Okay, this is the composition of Padma Award Committee, which is very, very important. Like we have seen, a maximum of 120 awards can be given. And so was it, like more than 20 awards were given under Padma Shri category. So all of them to be discussed are irrelevant for us. But first in all the categories can be considered. So if we consider in 1954 when the award was constituted, in science and engineering category, Homi Jahangir Baba was given the Padma Award first. And they are from Maharashtra. Then Mahadeva Ayyar Ganapati under civil service, they are from Odisha. And then Maithili Sharan Gupta under literature and education from Uttar Pradesh. V.L. Mehta under public affairs from Gujarat. Okay, Jamini Roy under arts from West Bengal. Then Satyanarayan Shastri under medicine, they are from Uttar Pradesh. Okay, these are also not that important, but you can just keep this in mind.
Gallantry Awards.
Every year, the Indian Honor System awards the act of bravery and sacrifices made by the officers, personnel of the armed forces and other lawfully constituted forces and civilians. The 6 Gallantry Awards are given by the government for the variety of services to the Republic of India. In today's video, we will talk about these awards and the meaning behind each one of them. The first 3 Gallantry Awards, namely Paramveer Chakra, Mahavir Chakra and Veer Chakra, were instituted by the government of India on 26th January 1952 post-independence, which were deemed to have come into effect from 15th August 1947. While the other 3 originally called as the Ashoka Chakra Class 1, the Ashoka Chakra Class 2 and the Ashoka Chakra Class 3 were introduced on 4th January 1952, which were also deemed to come into effect from 15th August 1947. Later in January 1967, the former 3 awards were renamed as the Ashoka Chakra, the Kirti Chakra and the Shaurya Chakra respectively. The first 3 Indian Gallantry Awards, namely Paramveer Chakra, Mahavir Chakra and Veer Chakra, are described as wartime awards, whereas Ashoka Chakra, Kirti Chakra and Shaurya Chakra are given as peacetime awards. Now we will explain some unique facts related to the design of the medal, the ribbon and the significance of all the 6 Gallantry Awards. Number 1. Paramveer Chakra. This is the highest gallantry awards for officers and other enlisted personnel of all military branches of India. It is awarded for the highest degree of valor or self-sacrifice in the presence of the national enemy, whether on land, at sea or in the air. If we talk about its literal meaning, then Paramveer Chakra denotes wheel or cross of the ultimate brave. The medal is circular in shape, made of bronze, is 1 3 inches in diameter and has 4 replicas of Indra's Vajra with the state emblem carved in the center. Now if you flip or reverse it to obverse, then it shall have embossed Paramveer Chakra both in Hindi and in English with 2 lotus flowers between the inscriptions. The medal's ribbon is of plain purple color. Now the interesting part is that if any recipient of the chakra shall again perform such an act of bravery that would make him eligible to receive the chakra, such further act of bravery shall be recorded by a bar to be attached to the ribbon by which the chakra is suspended. And for every such additional act of bravery, an extra bar will be added. This is applicable for all the other 5 gallantry awards as well. Number 2. Mahavir Chakra. This is the second highest gallantry award, which is given for the acts of conspicuous gallantry in the presence of the enemy. It can be given posthumously, meaning after the death of the originator. Since the inception of the medal, more than 218 acts of bravery and selfless courage have been recognized till 2017. The size, color and shape of all 6 medals are same. However, in Mahavir Chakra, a 5-pointed heraldic star is carved with the points of star just touching the rim. In center of the star is a domed glided state emblem, whereas on the reverse side of the medal, Mahavir Chakra is written both in Hindi and English with 2 lotus flowers in between. The ribbon of the medal is of half white and half orange color. The most Mahavir Chakras awarded in a single conflict were in the Indo-Pakistan War of 1971, when 11 medals were given to the Indian Air Force. Number 3. Veer Chakra. The Gallantry Medal is awarded for acts of bravery in the battlefield. The Veer Chakra Medal is made of standard silver with a 5-pointed heraldic star is moulded on it. In the center, the star shall have a chakra and within the chakra shall be a domed centerpiece bearing the glided state emblem. On the reverse side of the medal, Veer Chakra is embossed both in Hindi and in English, where the 2 versions are separated by 2 lotus flowers. The ribbon is half blue and half orange in color. It is the 3rd in precedence in the wartime gallantry award. Number 4. Ashok Chakra. It is the highest military award during peacetime. Ashok Chakra is awarded for valor, courageous or sacrifice away from the battlefield, and it is also awarded to civilians. It can be awarded either to military or civilian personnel or also posthumously. The circular shaped medal with rims on both sides shall be of gold gilt. On the face of the medal, a replica of Ashok's chakra is embossed in the center, surrounded by a lotus wreath. On the inner side, along the rim, shall be a pattern of lotus leaves, flowers and birds. On the reverse side, the word Ashok Chakra is carved both in Hindi and English, separated by two lotus flowers. The medal is of green-colored ribbon, which is divided into two equal segments by an orange vertical line. Number 5. Kirti Chakra. The fifth in the series is Kirti Chakra, which is awarded to both military personnel and civilians for the valor, courageous attempt or self-sacrifice away from the battlefield. The award is for peacetime and is equivalent of the Mahavir Chakra. Kirti Award is the second precedence of peacetime gallantry awards after Ashok Chakra. As described earlier, the award was previously called as Ashok Chakra II. The making of this award is very similar to Ashok Chakra, just that the medal shall be of silver gilt. And on the reverse shall be embossed the word Kirti Chakra, of course both in Hindi and English, and the two versions of writing being separated by two lotus flowers. The ribbon of Kirti Chakra is of green color, which is divided into three equal parts by two orange vertical lines. Number 6. Shaurya Chakra. Similarly to Ashok Chakra and Kirti Chakra, Shaurya Chakra is also a peacetime gallantry medal awarded for an act of bravery. It is a circular bronze medal with a green ribbon divided into four equal parts by three vertical lines. The award is equivalent to Veer Chakra and generally awarded for counter-insurgency operations and bravery actions against the enemy during peacetime. Before 1967, the award was known as the Ashok Chakra III. Here are some honorable mentions of the highest military awards in the world. In India, Paramveer Chakra. In Italy, Medal of Valor. In Germany, Iron Cross. In Japan, Order of the Rising Sun. In United Kingdom, Victoria Cross. In France, Croix de Guerre. In USA, Medal of Honor. So guys, this was our video on the highest gallantry awards in India.
So I hope you have understood these topics. So write down short notes about each awards. So thank you very much.